Thank you, Donna. Welcome back to Studio 10. We're joined by guest host Peter FitzSimons today. Peter, you've written... He's a popular guy now. You've written over 20 books. You're Australia's top-selling non-fiction author, and you've got a new one out called Gallipoli. The hint's in the title.
I've never been able to come up with clever titles. The only clever title I had was my third book was called Hitchhiking for Ugly People. And that seemed to go well.
Well, what's this one about?
The essence of it, look, my books, I try to make them live and breathe. I try to make them feel like you're not in Mr. Smithers' history class on a wet Wednesday afternoon, but you're there as the bullets whistle, as the rest of it. I suppose this one, the one story I wanted to share with you very quickly, I work with a lot of researchers, about four or five researchers, trying to sort of turn over the ground to find new stuff and to tell it in a different way. One of them is a very strong feminist, a stronger feminist than me, and she said to me at the end of the book, we haven't got enough women in here, you know, you've got too many men. Anyway, very quickly, so I added the story at the end. Her name was Nurse Lydia King. So she goes, she was from Orange, she went to Prince Alfred Hospital. She's one of the 25 nurses that land with 20,000 soldiers. Naturally, the 20,000 soldiers gravitate. One of them is Lieutenant Gordon Carter. They meet, they fall in love. He is on the shores of Gallipoli on the 25th of April. She's on the hospital ship and she is bathed in blood. You know, it's just awful. And every time she looks, is it Gordon? It's not Gordon. They both survive. They get married in 1916. Their first child is conceived around and about the 11th of November, 1918. He is a rat of Tobruk. Mm. Not a bad pedigree. You're a rat of Tobruk. Both your dad and your mum were at Anzac Day. He's a rat of Tobruk. He's still alive. And he's my Uncle Ted.
Really?
Wow.
Not bad, is it?
Yeah, it's great. And he and Auntie Mary have been married for 68 years. And he was the one that first told me about Tobruk when I really got interested. We were up at breakfast in Tamworth and he was moving salt and pepper shakers around. And I went, gee, that's a good story. Mm. And I didn't realise until my cousins hammered it into my head. You know, if you're doing Gallipoli, you've got to tell the story.
There's been so much written about Gallipoli.
Hasn't been done, Sandra, until I've done it. Okay, when I've done it, then it's been done.
Well, one of the interesting things, because you lance a few sacred cows in the book as well. You've been talking about how Gallipoli has been over mythologised at the expense of some of the
I have to be very careful on all that stuff because, I mean, I deeply admire Paul Keating. When they formed the Paul Keating fan club, there's no clapping coming on there.
I love Paul Keating,
but Paul Keating says, Gallipoli, I haven't been there, I won't go there, this was, you're celebrating, you know, a massacre, not a massacre, but fighting for Great Britain and the rest of it. And I absolutely understand where he's coming from, but when I walk around the gravestones of Lone Pine or any cemetery, my primary feeling is we've got to remember these blokes. We've got to remember what this was about. Although my friend Peter Brune in Adelaide makes a very good point that if you're an Australian soldier and you die, there's no higher... John Howard, in fact, said it at the War Memorial. There's no hierarchy of sacrifice. If you died at Gallipoli, you're no better a man than if you died in Vietnam, than if you died in the Korean War. You know, it can be overblown. But for me, what I was fascinated by, why do we, 100 years later, particularly remember this story?
Mm. Have I got? I think, yeah.
It was courage against all odds. Mm.
Have I got? It was, but as displayed. Have I got time for one more 30-second story?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anzac Centenary Advisory Board professor from Monash University told us the story, and the story was that in 1916, Battle of Pozieres, out of no man's land, comes a soldier, and he's got all the uniforms off him, and he's bleeding. And they say, "Who are you?" And he says, "Dunno. Where are you from? Dunno. Where's your who are you fighting with? Dunno." And the news comes back to Australia. They get him back. They put him in Heidelberg Repatriation Hospital. They say, "We found this bloke. Doesn't know who he is." 300 families from around Australia say, that's our boy Jack. Mm. He must be alive. They send them, it's not. They find out in 1927 that he's a Kiwi. They send him to New Zealand. His mother is waiting for him at the bottom of the gangplank. Jack, you're alive. Who are you? Mm-hmm. He died in a mental hospital. My point being that this war was not something glorified. It was devastating. 60,000 dead Australians, 150,000.
I think that's Keating's point, you know, is that it's been over-glorified. But, you know, you put it in context. And if you'd like to get your hands on a copy of Gallipoli by Peter FitzSimons, it's available now from all good bookstores. Well done, Pete.
Thank you.